Okay, Heidi, we're going to be talking about activity 3.1.2 today, which is product life cycle. We're going to talk about the life and, you know, production process and what you actually do with those materials after an object has fulfilled its usefulness and it's gone through its life expectancy and it's ready to no longer be used. There's tons of things in real life that you only use them for a brief amount of time. The number one thing that I can think of that will relate to most people is your cell phones. Your cell phones, you may think right now that you're going to have this thing for a really long time, but sometimes you drop it or it cracks or anything like that, or it just gets way too old and then you have to get rid of it. And what happens to all of those things inside the cell phone once you get rid of it? Does it just get thrown in the trash? Is there any way that you could possibly take some of those and reuse them? And so this is going to talk basically about the life cycle of a product. So how a product is made and what happens to a product after it's fulfilled its usefulness. Every product has a usefulness that goes along with it. So basically, you have a cycle that occurs. So you have this raw material, dig it up out of the ground, or you harvest it, or there's got to be some type of way to get a, you know, a raw material, and then you process the materials. It gets produced, put together, assembled. Then you have to ship it to people in order to actually have people use those. It finally goes through the distribution, so it gets shipped out, and then it gets used. And then after its usefulness, it either gets thrown away or it gets recycled. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. And let's see here. The first thing that we're going to do in class is I'm going to give out a series of objects. And if you're virtual, the objects that we're going to use are these. I've got two objects here. One of them is a cup that has, it's a regular drink cup. And then on the other side is a non-disposable one. So one of these is meant to be thrown away like instantly. So if you can think about like the use life of it, how long is this object actually intended to be used? So, you know, how long is the one on the right intended to be used, and how long is the one on the left intended to be used? Either way, they both have a specific life expectancy. So you can actually, you know, and you're going to get different values for those. So, all right. Now, what we're going to need to do is we're going to conduct what's called an inventory analysis of one of these objects. So for virtual, let's do the one on the right. So let's do the drink cup from a fast food place. Okay, and I'm going to show you guys what the inventory analysis looks like. What you're going to do is you're going to identify the types of raw material that it comes from. So you might have to look up a little bit, and you need to keep this in mind, though, because if you're looking at it and you say that it is plastic, well, plastic by itself is not a raw material. You don't dig plastic up out of the ground. So you may have to Google and find out where plastic actually comes from in order to write down the raw material that it comes from. If it's plastic, the plastic is a processed material. So the materials processing is where you would actually write down things like, see where it says list type of metal or plastic, okay? And if it's metal, you're going to have to tell me what kind of metal it came from. If it's an alloy, so like if you said that it was steel, you don't dig steel up out of the ground. You have to dig up raw materials in order to create steel. So any raw material has to be processed in order to become a usable material. Very rarely do you just pull something up and be like, well, we got it. It's usually not going to happen. And then you're going to actually have to think about the manufacturing process. What parts get put together and what will it actually take? So it says that for the manufacturing process, we just have to list all the different parts and pieces. Sometimes these are easy. Sometimes these are a little bit more complicated. And then for packaging, think about how these things actually made it to their destination. So both of these were not produced on the spot, so there's going to be some shipping that was involved with it. And you're going to just have to kind of use your imagination on how you think that these objects actually made it to their destination. So you can pick any one of those that you think is appropriate. Now keep in mind that these actually increase and decrease on the point value. The point value, if you look at it, it says, like, you know, if it's just like plastic only versus paper or cardboard, paper or cardboard gets a lower amount of points than plastic. The higher the score, the more of an impact that it creates on the area around us. So, like for example, plastic is nice and cheap, but you once you throw away plastic, it kind of sticks around for a long time. It's hard to get rid of. So it's got a relatively high score because it leaves a pretty big impact. And you can kind of see that if you've ever seen somebody like throw away like a milk jug or something like that on the side of the road, that stays there for like ever and ever and ever. But if you throw away like a piece of cardboard, it usually deteriorates a lot faster than a piece of plastic would. Okay, think about the distribution. How did it actually make it here? The answer is, was it distributed or was it not? If it's produced on the spot, that's a pretty low impact that you have. Okay, utilization. So how long is this thing intended to actually be used? Is it only meant to be used once? Has it been meant to be used for 5 years, or is it supposed to be used for 10 years plus? So keep that in mind. The shorter the lifespan, how long it's actually intended to be used, the greater the impact that's going to have, because you're going to just use it once and then you're going to throw it away. It's a one and done. Okay, and then disposal. So if you have to throw it away and you don't have any other option, that's going to be a high impact value. Some of the product materials can be recycled. That's going to be medium. And if you can recycle all of the materials, then that's going to give you a very, very low impact because all of those materials can be reused for something else later on down the line. So we have to not only think about ourselves and the things that we're making now, you have to think about the people like 20, 50, 100, 150 years from now that are still around and making things. You know, what is their environment going to look like? What is their space going to look like? How is our impact going to affect them? And things always impact other people. So you're going to have to try to minimize that impact in order to get it to actually have some type of sustainable system. Okay, and let's see here. What do we got here? We've got the raw material extraction, manufacturing, packaging. All of that stuff is on the inventory analysis template. And then afterwards, after we're done with all of those, you find the sum of each step, and then you're going to find the sum of all the steps, and then you're going to add them all up. Okay, and then you're going to do the next thing for the one on the left. So you're going to do the styrofoam cup first, and then you're going to do the exact same thing, but you're going to do it with the reusable drinking cup. Okay, so we're going to do that. So what I'm going to need from you guys is I'm going to need an impact analysis of the styrofoam cup on the right side and the metal cup on the left side. And that'll do it for the first part, and we'll do the next part later, but we're just going to kind of keep this in usable chunks here. So have a great day, and I will talk at you guys later.